Hi, this is Sword Champion, and today I'm gonna go over how to warrior in fractals. I haven't been watching any of the latest guides, but I felt like, you know, making my own and going off my own experience. So, I think there's three main warrior builds that should be used in fractals. One of the main ones, almost all teams should have it, is a PSEA warrior, or phalanx strength empower allies warrior. This type of warrior is kind of like the team might booster and fury stacker. This warrior should be able to maintain 28% crit chance for the team and about 25 might stacks and all that good stuff. Alright, let's start with the basics. The traits. Traits are going to be as follows: 0 on strength, 5 in arms, 0 defense, 6 in tactics, and 3 on discipline. You can trade off for 3 on discipline to the other traits, like maybe put a strength or defense or something like that for a little extra healing. Putting it on defense would up your survivability by quite a bit because of the traits and adrenal health. Then maybe arms. And 2 in strength for great fortitude. So if you go ahead and do that, you get your furious, which gives you all that good stuff. And then you get your great fortitude. That'll take you around 25k HP on this build that I'm about to introduce to you. Other than that, I keep mine at 05063, mainly for the Signet Mastery and the weapon swaps, because I love swapping weapons really fast. Alright, your traits are going to be as follows. On arms, it's going to be 1, which is Deep Strike. Gain precision for each unused Signet you have equipped. That means you have 1, 2, 3 Signets usually. You lose 2% critical when you use your Signet of Rage, but, you gain Fury. And next one is going to be Crack Shot. Not crack shot, my bad. Forceful greatsword. Sorry. This trait, gain might on a critical hit with a greatsword or spear, and reduce recharge on greatsword and spear skills by 20%. So this is your main, this will sync up with one of your other main traits, and that will provide the might stacks to the team. Alright, next one is attack opportunity. Increase damage if bleeding grows by 10%. Works really well on teams since everyone gets bleeding anyway. Alright, next traits are as follows. 5 in tactics for the banner. As a PSEA warrior, you want to take a discipline banner with you almost all the time. If another warrior is running discipline and he's not traded for banners, go ahead and tell them to switch or ask them to kindly switch to a different banner. Because this is the bread or butter, one of the things that you want in your build. The permanent discipline banner. So around 2 seconds that you don't have it up, but other than that, it's almost a 100% maintenance rate. Alright, the next trait is going to be empower allies. So you're giving 150 points of power to your team around a 600 radius. It only activates in combat, but it's pretty helpful. That's how you maintain all the damage for your team. This build does have quite a bit of good DPS pushed out, but the main point of it is to might up your team and keep them critting a lot more than they usually would. Alright, for the next last one is going to be Phalanx Strength, or Phalanx. So when you've got yourself might, grant 10 nearby allies as well. Radius is 600, or the same as your empower allies. A lot of stuff in the fractals dungeon, involves stacking or close combat, so the range shouldn't really matter unless you're range fighting a boss, then you switch builds. So it's gonna go with the Forceful Greatsword every time you crit. So let's go ahead and switch to Greatsword. I have 2 different Greatswords. I have a one with accuracy. All your weapons should have accuracy on them for the crit rate or crit chance. So accuracy, and then there's a Might Sigil. 1 second cooldown, 60% chance to gain might. This is gonna get you to 25 might stacks a lot faster than without it. Then there's another one for Bloodlust. So it helps out. You charge it with Bloodlust first, and then when you get like near 20 stacks, you just switch to your Might one. Because my axe, secondary weapon set, has the Bloodlust rune also, so it keeps it there. Because when you do switch weapons and you don't have a weapon with Bloodlust at all, in either on your first weapon set or secondary, then you're going to lose the stacks. So the greatsword's there. Your weapons should be Zerka or Assassin for the critical. You can go Knights for a little tankier PSA warrior, but either or, I mean, it's up to the player. Either they want to do DPS or they want, you know, tank, be a little tankier. For the armor set, it's going to be full Zerkers or full Assassins or full Knights, something with precision. You can go Magi's if you want for a little bit more HP, that helps a lot. In higher runs, when mods are almost two-shotting you, three-shotting you, you know, you can take that extra hit. Alright, for the runes on the armor, it's going to be mainly runes of strength. So superior rune of strength, it's going to give you a, I think, 45% might duration boost. You can also use runes of Holbrek and some other weird rune that gives strength, might boon duration, but strength would be your best bet. Yes, it is expensive, but it is worth forking it. You know, the extra gold for it. You're gonna get travelers too. It's a 50% boon duration for almost all the boons, but you know, it's kind of like you're missing that 30%. It helps a lot. Now, for your trinkets should have must have precision on them. It doesn't matter what kind. It could be Magi's, could be Assassin, could be like maybe Celestial. But they should have precision on them. Don't put like a PTB ring or, you know, all that other stuff. That doesn't really work. Alright, underwater combat, again, just put the strength rune on there. Doesn't matter what kind of breather you have. Underwater weapons, it's up to you as long as it has a 7% crit chance on the spear. Because that's also going to give might stacks to your team. Oops. Because of Forceful Greatsword. Alright, that's most of the intro. For your utilities, healing should always be healing signet. Fights really last quite a while sometimes for bosses. Healing signet would be the best heal for the warrior. Because if you do factor it out, you know, the overtime healing that you get from that out heals almost every other heal out there that you can put on. Since you're trading for signets, you can spam it a little faster, like 4 seconds faster. Alright, for your second utility, always for Great Justice. You want this skill. This is going to give the might stacks to the team. Just standing there, you can give about 11 might stacks to the team for about 11 to 12 seconds. And then you go bash the boss in, and it'll get 25 might almost immediately. For your second one, if you have a low crit chance, like right now I have 67, with Fury and Banner that's around like 80 something, and Food is like 99, 100%. You can opt for Signet of Might if you can, you know, if you can afford losing a few, a little bit of crit chance. But for the most part, I suggest Signet of Fury. It'll give you the extra 8% almost crit chance since you're traded for, you know, more sigil, more precision on sigils and stuff. And this will maintain your crit chance over 100%. This is without Food because you're getting 93 and then you get the banner. So the banner up, 81%, and with Fury up, you're 101%. Boom. No need to use Food or anything. But if you're putting my signet, I'm at 93%. So I just lost like, what, like 8%-ish, whatever. But I do gain the power, and that helps a little bit. You can keep up with the DPS, compare those full Zerk guys, and you're also giving them might. So they don't have to worry about it, maintaining it for themselves. So as you can see, I have a banner up, and for Great Justice is charged. You can cycle these as a PSA warrior. Properly traded and properly built, you can give permanent fury to the team. Just pick up your banner. Skill 2, drop it for Great Justice, swing, maintain those might attacks, 100 blades for some might. Alright, time it right, pick it up again, about a second left, boom, drop another fury for the team, you're at 18 seconds fury. So that you still have fury for the team, that means you still have fury. Alright, whirl, you know, normal auto attacks, pick it up again, There's another Fury, and there's another For Great Justice coming out. Take note that I don't have food right now, so it's, you know, 20%, all that good stuff. Still swinging, picking it up. Another Fury. Bam, at this rate, you're still in a fight, you're doing damage, you're maintaining a might, and you're maintaining a Fury on the team. And for yourself, throw in a Great Sword burst attack to give yourself almost permanent Fury.
For great justice.
So poof, 19 seconds. This goes up a little bit on the food I use. I use the bountiful strength runes. Or bountiful, sharpening stones. So it's like 10% more boon duration, also 100% power, so my power is going to be quite high. It's not gonna be as much damage as the 66002 or 66020 warrior builds, but it's gonna keep up. The damage is around, you know, 25, 26, 100 blades, and it's probably like not booted. It's also not, I think, not including many bone stacks, just a couple. Alright, and that is the introduction to the PSEA Warrior. Oh, actually, hold on. Weapon set, secondary. I have an axe and a fractal war. Oh, well, not warwood, just warhorn. Okay, the first weapon could be anything you want. It could be like a freaking mace, it could be like a sword, whatever. As long as it. The main reason I use this for is the bloodlust. You know, just charge it up once in a while. On trash mobs, I go for axe, and then, you know, on the stuff that I need to give the team might for, I go for greatsword. So, main reason I take Warhorn as secondary instead of like shield or mace or anything like that for weakness vulnerability is for the charge, which removes cripple, all this good stuff from your team, not just you. And also call to arms. You know, weakness on the boss for 6 seconds, that's 6 seconds of fumble. So, you know, instead of the boss shooting out 10k, 15k damage, you know, just like poof, 3k, 4k, whatever. Alright, also, since this is a PSA warrior build, you have traits on tactics, so secondary tactics and power allies, you can switch that off for quick breathing. Reduces recharge of warhorn skills, warhorn skills convert conditions into boons. This is an awesome freaking trait. Usually, if there's another warrior, I ask them to trade in power, and I'll take quick breathing. With this, you can maintain... that you can ensure that your team is not getting slain by like 15 bleed stacks and all that, and you can maintain vigor a little better on this build or on this trait than you would a normal untraded. So vigor is a very helpful skill, helps a lot in 49 fractals when you know you do less damage with less endurance, and also the 30s where you know your endurance is halved, so putting up a vigor would make it recharge just as fast as normal. It helps a lot because, you know, dodges save lives and people need to dodge. Other than that, go back to the main weapon. Alright, for your range weapons, you are going to be carrying either longbow, which is, again, 7% crit chance, and it's up to you. Either you want to put a might rune, a might sigil on it to maintain the might while ranging, or I go for steel health, because, you know, range fights, you usually take a while. So I steal health, maintain it, because the health stealing helps with my heal signet. And maybe the Guardian's, like, battle presence, or, you know, someone's regen, Ellie's water, magic stuff, whatever it helps, it stacks, and it gives you a shit ton of HP. I usually take rifle, because on range fights, all you usually do is switch forceful greatsword to crack shot, and poof, done. Rifle's traded and good to go. Same stuff. I usually switch builds. If it's a range boss, I switch builds completely, and armor sets, depending on that. PSA Warrior, if you can afford it. Some are pretty cheap, some are not, but, you know, I've got a Zerka set with Travelers, so... The speed boost helps sometimes, most of the time against bosses. People don't notice it, but you know, you run way slower without a speed boost, even though you're in combat. There's also a nice traveler set that I rock, you know, for a little extra tanky. You know, take a couple hits, maybe 2-3 more hits, because the damage, the toughness helps a lot. For me, that is. And there's also the Scholar Berserker set, you know, for when I want to go all out and improve. This is just one of those play sets that I'm planning on salvaging anyway. And the current set is going to be Zerker. I'm not a big fan of Zerker. Full Zerker. I mean, it's really squishy. That armor is really, really low. I mean, I know how to dodge and all, but, you know, if you take that one random hit, you're kind of screwed. So, you know, sometimes I prefer to be better safe than sorry. But for this one, I'm going to go Full Zerker. So Full Zerker, Full Zerker. Here's the stats. This is Full Ascended, and this is Full Ascended. And these are the stats on Full Ascended, Zerker PSEA Warrior. Alright, quick little demo. I'm going to go and find something to attack. Go over here. And we got an ore. Since usually mobs there last a little longer than other mobs. Maybe I can go to like Frost Gorge or something, but we're already mapping ore. Alright, give it a bit to load. Since I'm vetting it, it takes a little longer. Alright, let's go and attack some stuff. Let's go attack that servant. Alright, the more things you hit with your greatsword, the faster you gain my sacks. So, usually, bam, drop a fear for the team. Drop it. Drop might and fear for the team, and here we go. 14, 15, 16, 18, 19. Almost immediately, I'm at 21 sacks of might. That means your team is around 22, 23 sacks of might. Because this thing gives them an extra 3 might. So whatever you get from that burst, or whatever you see on my screen, is add 3 might to that and how much your team has. Alright, so your team right now is at 25 might stacks. Good to go. Another fury for the team, and then just go at it. And you notice my crit rate is 95%.
Give me something to pummel.
It's a little higher with food, because I usually food up anyway. Oh, there we go. My attacks are going up. Remember, spam these two skills during fight and poof. That's about it for PSEA Warrior starter. I'm going to give it a tutorial later.
Hold this position.
For playing it in fractals. How to maintain it, all that good stuff, etc, etc. Alright, other build would be just to switch off. If you're going for like a boss that you don't really need banners and all that good stuff, switch off of that. 6 in arms, 5 in defense, boom, you've got a solid build. You have Furious, you have Dogged March, or maybe Vigorous Turn, either or. So you usually put Dogged March, and then Cleansing Ire, which removes conditions for every bar of adrenaline. Your Furious is going to charge your adrenaline, and then you use, you know, you burst for the condition removal. This helps a lot on Mai if you're using a great bow, because those burst skills go, you know, just fly out fast. And then you have armored attack, which gains, you know, a little bit more power depending on your armor. Right now I'm at 2. You know, that much power, and the stats are like so. So it's not too bad for 2.5k armor, 2.5k power, 91 crit chance. That's without the banner, by the way. If another warrior takes it, good on them. So
for great justice.
Poof. And I usually take Signet of Stamina for the dodges and stuff. Helps a lot. Especially when you're doing a ranged fight, you don't really want to switch to your secondary weapon set and you drop the vigor. Helps a little bit. Also in like 49 fractals and all that good stuff. The DPS remains sort of alright. Alrighty. And this is basically the tanky DPS warrior. You do have a fairly good amount of power coming out. And then, you know, your crit chance is almost 100 and your crit damage is pretty well. Someone drop a banner and poof, it skyrockets. Everything skyrockets. And now range fights, again, crack shot, and for melee fights, forceful greatsword. And this stays the same discipline for all my builds, usually stays the same. My next one is going to be 660, either 20 or 02. So let's get rid of that, go back to this, and go all the way up on that. Alright, I'll usually put Great Fortitude for this. The HP helps a bit, you know, conditions and whatnot. Alright, next one is Slashing Power. If you're doing a Greatsword, you can go Axe. If you're doing like a range fight, I would suggest going crack shot on arms, and then after that go axe mastery, because your secondary is an axe, and that will hit quite a bit. All right, and last trait is Zerker's power. So depending on your adrenaline bars, you're going to do more damage. So with Furious up there, and you know, you're swinging your stuff, it's quite a bit of damage. All right, going back to Greatsword on this, and this one's going to be Slash Power. All right, notice that the power didn't go up much, maybe like 200 points, but you did lose critical, well, not really, you didn't lose critical damage. Yeah, critical damage went down by 4%, you know, your armor went down quite a bit. I prefer the tanky DPS build, to be honest, or you can just go like, you can go 4, 6, 0, 0, 4, sharpen axes, you're training for axes, because you know, your secondary is good. And poof, there you go, you have 213% crit chance, or crit damage, sorry. Power only went down by 100. And you get your weapon switching. That's about it. I prefer this build over the 66002. Mainly because probably I like the ferocity. And you do get mad adrenaline, that like super fast adrenaline gains with an axe. You do keep the bleeding foes, 10%. And then this one you just lose like maybe 18% damage. It's a lot, yes, but you don't really need that much because everyone's hitting ham on him. Alright, this is the build for the supportive type. I would go 66020 and put inspiring banners. That way your team will have a banner for them. So this, these stats here, you lose quite a bit of critical, but when you up the support banner, poof, done, good to go. So you do a little bit more damage. You still maintain that fury for the team. Not as well, because you're losing a lot of seconds on it. And, you know, you're doing a crap ton of damage. This is the other, you know, the DPS. I rarely use this build. I prefer going the tanky DPS, because, you know, it's more survival and condition removal and extra regen. Also, damage isn't much difference. The only big difference is the 15% you get from strength, which is, you know, I'm spamming burst skills anyway, so I don't have 15%. Like, I don't have full adrenaline most of the time. The burst skills are there. I do love this build though. This one, the 6-5. Oops. There we go. 6503. Because then I don't have to, like, I really don't switch discipline out a lot. It's just, it's there. Because the weapon switching, love it. Only 5 seconds to wait. Or less, maybe 4. And then you get your Signet Mastery, and you do get the Ferocity from that. And Ferocity helps a lot. So here we go. And that's the stuff. I mean, you've got quite a bit of crit damage, since you're on banner anyway. And DPS is still there. And crit chance is still there, but you do have a lot more armor than you would on the 66 build. And that's about it. I'm gonna do a run later, or prefer, possibly after this part of the video, and attach it to it. And then I will demonstrate how to play Warrior and Fractals. She dogs are usually crazy. Alright, here we go. Let me drop some food. Alright, make sure.
I will get the first wall.
Who's down, guys? Oh, it's gonna start slaughtering the lag on me a little bit. Fuck. It's fine. Let's go. Alright, so PSA Warrior. The build is on the video. Let me put my armor on real quick because I have the wrong set of armor for this.
Alright, well, I'm gonna start without you.
Alright, go ahead. I'm putting the right greatsword on too. And I'm good to go.
Alright, wall.
You're tired. Alright, I'm working on the Fury Stacks now. Ah, shit.
We're already going.
Yeah.
Shield.
Give me
shield.
A sec, I'll start getting the might up. Alright, and here we go. I guess for PSA Warrior, So you guys spam your TS skills like so. So I do start off with 100 blades. 100 blades is out. It's around 20k-ish. A little bit over, around 24k damage. It's alright. Less than the DPS one build. Your burst skill is going to give you 21 seconds of fury, and you want 100% crit chance. I'm currently on Fury Signet because I'm not using food for the extra fury. I'm using a lifesteal food that I just dropped. Here we go. So 100 blades, and then the combo is 100 blades, whirlwind attack, and then you're going to do a blade trail, and then rush, and then repeat. And once in a while, I'll put your arching slice up for that fury to you. That's my banner. Alright, also, during the fight, you pick up your banner, use skill 2 real quick, and you go back to the fight. That'll give your team fury, and as you see here, they have 18 seconds. Since I recently put up for Great Justice, and I think Ark has it too. So pick it up. Banner 2 for Great Justice, that's going to keep that fury on your team, that's going to give them a constant 28% crit chance. That's quite a lot, and if you stack that onto a Ranger Smiter skill, they're going to have like 33-ish. So for the most part, most teams are going to hit 100% or near 100% crits. Maybe like 80-90% crits. Mobs will melt, and the runs will go faster. Oh shit, sorry guys, you can go insane if you want.
I wasn't even wearing my full cert.
I was wearing full cert. Alright, hang on, let me switch gear for this.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go knight so I can kite.
Darn it. Well, I'm gonna pause a bit and close some programs and stuff so that I stop lagging.
Yes. I got strength in numbers.
Alright.
Alright, sweet. Vid is back on. Here you go. So, speed boost for the team. Let's go. Alright, for the warrior, I usually carry Axe Warhorn as secondary set, unless I'm ranging, which I rarely do. It's mostly melee for this. Secondary is Warhorn, because when you trait and power allies off for, quick breathing, you do get the Warhorn recharge rate, 20%, and also the condition removal, which helps a lot on some of the bosses. Might trade and all that good stuff. Alright, so let's go down.
Hey, wait. No problem. You guys all know the stabbing trick, right?
Stabbing, yeah, you keep stabbing the,
Yeah, I'm gonna put up, like, walls with staff and hammer and wall with wall of reflection to guard. So just keep stabbing. Pearls, can you trade off with me halfway through?
Okay.
Sweet. Alright, make sure everyone's on a hammer, and, wait, before we do this, make sure your skills are hold the line, stand your ground, and while we're going to do that thing we did on the 49 and just kill the Ellie, meet the center.
Alright.
I have to change them after this.
Yeah. Make sure you're
You can get out of combat, though, after this.
Yeah, it's not a lot of time, though. Yeah, that's fine. Ready when you guys are.
Alright.
Ready.
Alright, as I was saying, Warhorn, for the vigor, swiftness, because a lot of people run scholars or some other stuff like that, want to go pew pew DPS. Help your team run faster. And that vigorous for 49 helps a lot, like a shit ton, because you are keeping that DPS up with your warrior. I think I might have explained that in the first part of this video with the builds and stuff. Sweet. I think Fog is over there, kiting the mobs. I'm gonna toss a vigor his way. And also weaken some mobs.
Alright, trade off.
Alright, here we go. Alright, I think we're good, guys. Go to the ice wall. Alright, so usually, sometimes if you have a good team, you can do a fury stack for the fight. You can use an Ellie or you can use a warrior, either or. For Great Justice and Banner 2, just keep stacking them over and over and everyone picks it up and, you know, goes for it. But for this boss, we don't need a fury stack and we're gonna go for it. Alright, here we go.
Alright, hollow ground down.
sweet. Alright, around like 7, 8, or before he goes and, you know, snore, let's try to get that, frost off. Yeah, Pearl, you gotta get that frost.
I got fire lit.
Sweet, thank you. Alright, dropping banner on top of him. And I meet you guys center, just go straight center. Go, go, go. Alright, lighting the fire. Fire's lit.
Alright. Wait, whoa, why are we going straight center?
Because you went there with us, but this is faster and safer than just... So what we do is we keep circling in 360, the allies will come to us like that, what they're doing now, and we just keep swinging and keep moving, and use the source to LOS the allies. We'll kill them and hit the source at the same time. See how this is working right now?
Yeah. Ah, shit.
Yeah, stand your ground.
Getting wrecked.
And walls. Yeah, just keep swinging. You're fine. It's better than standing.
Alright, haul the ground down.
Casual mistake.
Yeah, so...
Filthy casuals, right?
We got like 8 allies here and none of us is dying, so it's pretty good. Alright, meet you center. And I need a...
Never move.
Yeah.
I need to get my stacks off.
Yeah, me too. Meet over
Where
there.
Where is the fire?
Over here.
There's
over
no
here,
torches.
Over here.
There's no torches.
We got the torches. There's fire over here.
Why would you go over there with them?
No, that's where they were.
There's a lot of torches.
Ah, crap, I'm down.
He's down. Alright, keep getting the source. There's an alley right there. Get that.
Down. Forget about
Thanks.
Me.
Thanks, he's got me. Alright, he's got me. I'm gonna go in Vengeance and try to hit this alley for a little bit more damage.
At least I get a swap back to my other gear.
We got one more snow and then a Zerg Fest after that. Don't forget your walls of reflection, and we should be good. And go.
Never do.
Yeah. There you go. So some
don't you?
Huh?
Don't you just love this greatsword?
Oh gosh.
And I know how much you love guardians using greatsword.
Greatsword guardians are so ew. I mean, I don't know. Hate them.
If we just kill this one, it'll make it easier.
Or just pull them in the middle. They'll die. Because they're gonna attack us anyway.
Not all of them actually. If we just stay on this side, we shouldn't get any of them.
Shouldn't? Yes, but I've already I've been on runs where we stand in a safe spot, like over here at the edge of it, and hit it, and pew, they still come anyway. We got the fire. Fire's up. There you go. Alright, so a little tip about fractals. You see this white circle around me? This is the range for the fire. If you can stand at the edge of it and hit the elemental source, you'll notice that I'm getting fire and also hitting the source at the same time. So once they light that fire, boom. On my screen, I'm getting warm and I'm also damaging the source. I mean, you can just basically stand here and AFK. Alright guys, just Zerg centered, I guess.
Alright, charge.
Heading for it. Oh god.
Circles. Look mom, I can draw a circle. Aren't you proud of me? Wall.
I'm using your wall. Oh, it hurts too much.
Oh, greatsword. Oh, I'm dead.
Where's that fire? I gotta find the fire.
Screw the fire, just finish off the source.
I'm on a 16 stacks, it's killing my regen. There we go. They just dip in the fire real quick, and then we'll go back to it.
Just finish it. Keep attacking.
I'm finishing it.
There yes, we go, I'm up.
Oh, everyone's like 20 stacks.
So many stacks.
Here, there's fire over here. Let's go.
Alright, Swift.
So for this boss, I'm talking to the dudes. For this upcoming boss, what I'm going to do is I'm going to maintain Permanent Fury on the team as a warrior, as a PSEA warrior. And the Mind Sacks will stay at 25, or let's hug right and just aggro the melee. Alright, also for this run, I'm going to trade for Quick Breathing real quick. That way, I can remove conditions from the team. Alright, ready? And hug right.
Jesus Christ.
So when the team does get crippled, and I'm going to stay here around the... Oh shit, they are dead. Alright.
It's alright, I'm gonna make it. Maybe.
I'll be right with you. I waited for the last member, so Shelv's over there. If Shelv gets crippled, I'm gonna immediately run back and shoot him a Warhorn 5 or 4 to remove that cripple, and so he doesn't get spiked down by these mobs. The Rangers are very annoying. I hate Rangers.
Made it. It's right, okay to checkpoint.
Sweet. And I'm OOC. Alright, so let's fury stack real quick before we go in the room. Here we go. Banner's up. You guys first. Justice up. I got next. Drop.
Take my dust.
Too soon.
I got it. Alright, let's go. We're good. We got 40 seconds of fury. That's a pretty boss fight. And then when we go in, I'm going to maintain it. So the team will have permanent fury. Alright, here we go. Starting the mic stack. Should it be 20? What you do as a PSA warrior, if you are committed to it, you can just fight the boss, attack, get the 20 mites up, pick your banner up, use number 2, and poof, go back to attacking. Alright, for this boss, usually just dodge one, boom. Dodge there and then stack immediately where I'm standing, and these things won't hit you. They fall in a pattern. Most people don't realize it because they run like the run around subway, but all you need is one evade and poof, you're done. Again, maintaining that fury on myself and all the team. And Argus also helping since he's a warrior. And we have about a minute of fury for the team. You don't really need elementalists for this stuff. They do damage, yes, but you know, a heavy team with Hammer Guardians, heavy is preferred. And I see... Oh, I thought you were frozen, Fog.
No, I was just doing the dodge back for his breathing. So I wasn't going to cleave you guys.
Okay, good. Alright, again, one evade, all it takes. Oh shit, that was too fast.
Screenshotted.
Don't do it.
Screenshotted.
Don't you dare screenshot that. Alright, banner's down. Maintain that fury while the boss is still up there.
Healing.
Thanks, I got it.
Oh, you're too far away.
Yeah, I'll send your symbols. I've got 8 stacks of this freezing thing, it hurts. It's 700 a second. Where's my banner at? There we go. Alright, picking up the banner, quick skill 2, it takes like 2 seconds.
Now there's the guardian. That guardian is just face tanking him.
Wow, just echoed for great justice there from Ark. I got it, Swan, I got the Alright, so pick the banner up. And evade. Boom. And here you are, just stack here. Alright, so you notice on the right side, they fall about the third one. 1, 2, 3, and then he's about to spawn. So, poof. And swing. Again, as you see, I'm maintaining the fury and might to the team. The Guardians are using their own powers, and I think Ark has a little bit of my sex with the team too. Actually, hold on, I'll ask. Alright, banner up. Oh shit, I'm frozen. Get that ice shard. Thank you, it's done. Oh shit.
Screenshot.
No. Alright, get him up. way more than the Fury. Alright, any spotting? 3, 2, 1.
Ooh, you were off with the count.
Hey, just like a little bit. Sorry,
just
I counted late.
Just put a delay on the video, no one will know.
Congrats. Alright, so we've got about almost 1 minute and 30 seconds of Fury. That's pretty good. Alright, please not cliffside.
And cliffside.
Give me like reactor or something. Yeah!
Did we get reactor?
Yeah, we got reactor.
Perfect. Can't wait till we get to the top.
Oh shit, this is 49. You're gonna do south, east, ooze, and take the east. East rod and then ooze rod and then run over there. Alright, banner's up. Yeah, let's go. Alright, so we want to guys, you guys want to split off to duo the south room or just go as a team?
Yeah, I can duo the south room with someone.
Alright, I'll go with you. And the rest of the team, I guess, go east and then we'll meet you at Ooze. So, Chev.
There was still a team to go where? Sorry.
Yeah, I'm going south with, is that you, Fog?
Yeah, with me.
South with Fog. Alright, for this thing, when the portal appears, evade immediately and you won't get pulled into it.
Or just have a guardian pop stability.
Well, that works too. Here's your normal pugs! You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah,
yes. By the way, on this part, when I jump up and hit the other portal, the next one to our left, and it's usually done around the same time the team is done with this. You can do a
short
blow 5.
Yep.
Oh,
we lost
5.
One.
Oh no.
Who did we lose?
Oh,
we lost 2.
Looks like someone doesn't know how to evade.
Right, oh my god,
let me,
you guys.
Let me do, hold on, stand here. Let me do
you guys, you guys, I got a spoon.
Oh shit, congrats.
Never mind, it's unbelievable.
Congratulations.
Let's go for
it. I just want the damn fork now.
Someday.
After watching that, so many people are gonna be like, oh my god, there's a fork, I've never had it drop.
Hopefully
it's like
you don't get a million.
Spoon and fork, then you can eat fractal meals.
Dude.
Oh gosh,
it unlocks the fractal collection.
Alright, we'll just, should I go thief on ooze for DPS, or actually
no,
I'm on PSP.
No, you're on warrior, right?
Yeah.
Showcase the Signet of Might, because not many warriors do it, and they need to know.
I got a spoon. Alright, sweet, I'm going south with you, and we'll go this portal. Stack on me, and I'll lure the vets onto us. You guys go east. Oh shit.
I'm already on my way south.
We need someone to go here.
Yeah, are we gonna kill these guys?
They went they went west. Yeah, come over here and stack on me.
Are we killing these guys?
Yeah, stack on me over here.
Okay.
This is a stack spot for these warriors and stuff.
Well, they're LOS now, so go for the portal so it doesn't spawn more.
The portal doesn't spawn more at all.
Really?
Yeah, just gotta kill the mobs.
I thought the portal kept spawning more.
Nope. You just have one little spawn. Oh shit, yeah, you're ready for the Eiffel's.
Oh no, no, sweet, they turned.
Oh gosh, I didn't want to get spiked down this early.
I hate those guys. Hang on, let me grab,
I've got stability.
Alright, I got wall of reflection. I'll take the bottom.
I'll take the left.
No.
You
want
to take
the I can get the switch through the wall. So right, just sweet. Go, stay here, and I'll tell you when to go, okay?
I'm going to go to the right one and open in the middle for you. My one is you guys good.
Okay, so where do you need help right now?
We're good.
Okay, it's open, go.
I'm going middle.
Okay.
Alright, I am not...
There...
Alright. You said you can get... Which side are you taking? Because I was going to get left, here. You get right, and then you open
here.
The middle for me.
Here, I'll show you. I'll show you what I mean as soon as we clear these guys. Alright, pick up your shield and come with me real quick. I'm gonna show you this.
Yeah, you do that.
Pop the shield and look, you can get through the wall here.
Alright.
You can actually get the switch.
Then...
So I'll let you in. Not many people know about that.
Yeah, I thought you meant middle. Alright, I'm here.
Go.
Alright, you're good.
Alright, I'm in.
Alright, go for it. Yeah, both?
Alright, got him, yeah.
Sweet. I'll meet you out of here. Oh, shit. What are you guys doing? Do you guys go east? Oh, Pearl, what are you doing?
He's trying to do the
He's a Norn, so he's got Become the Bear.
Oh, yeah. My bad.
But he is on a Guardian. I don't know if it'll work as well on the Guardian.
Guardians get heals, though, and I think invulnerability for 2 seconds. So.
I don't think invulnerability skills work in there.
Oh, yeah. My bad. Well, they do have heals, and they do have heals. Oh,
yeah.
Heals.
I mean, we'll put one rod in for him and then just see if he can make it.
Yeah. East rod is done, so let's go for it. All right, stack on me. Normal, our usual stack spot for these on top. I'm going to work on that portal. Oh, come on. Got it. There's a rod here, by the way, on us.
Yeah, I don't know who brought it.
Someone stole it. Wolves. Ice wolves.
Pearls.
Babe.
Oh,
yes.
Wolf. Are you going in the heat room right now?
I'm gonna try.
Yeah,
do you have a rod?
No.
There's a rod on here, someone stole it.
Yeah.
Holy crap.
Yeah, no, just go for it. But what you do is you activate Become the Bear before you go in. And then when you're in, you hold down the 5 key. And then it should get you most of the way.
Yeah, I just evades. Oh, use your shout skill that gives you, like, regen and all that good stuff. That helps a bit.
Save yourself.
Yeah.
Hang on, storage. One second.
Alright, so for the ooze boss, there's multiple ways of doing them. Most teams find them out there. We will pull them over here to a good spot. And then, the main reason why we do this is because the warriors can whirl on the wall and do, you know, the max damage with their whirls that they can. So whirlwind attack over here. It's gonna be like that.
But it also takes all the blue oozes longer to get to you.
Yeah, it'll also take blue oozes longer to get to the team. With a thief, you can pull them all the way up to here. And that works pretty well.
Another nice thing is for Guardian, you can just sanctuary him against the wall and it'll just keep CCing him.
Oh yeah. Sounds good.
So that's what I'm gonna do. Yeah, Pearls did not make it. Yeah, let's just
Oh my god. Him. I was so close.
Yeah, just res dude. Yeah, I think you can res. There you go. Just don't use your
I can res.
You can. It takes a long time, 149, but you can res eventually. It's just 2 cycles, because your res thing's going to fill up and improve. Alright, so here we go. I'm going to do the ooze. Okay, when he blocks, I'm going to use Signet of Might here to make myself unblockable. That means while he's doing his overload shield, I can damage him. This works also
mainly CC him.
Yep. What do you mean?
Then the rest of the group can attack.
I can't. I don't have CC skills. I'm going to put shield on.
Put on any weapon, yeah.
Alright, just make sure you guys don't take off his stack, so.
Well, I will after you do that with Sanctuary.
Yeah, I'll
just pin him against the wall.
Depends if he's got Defiance or not. Alright, so I'll just go ahead and wipe and meet us over here.
Well, if that's the case, I can just go run a rod over there real quick.
Yeah,
since we're gonna have to wait for him anyway.
We'll take both rods over there. And then poof.
Alright.
Yeah, Pearl, go ahead and wipe.
Alright, we can
get up,
Yeah, no, let him get up. We can four-man ooze.
Yeah. Alright, shoot, let's go. And... Are we all here?
Yeah, all but Pearls.
Start fury stacking.
Alright, yeah, you go start pulling.
I'm gonna go and, block his... I'm gonna be a target on the ooze. There you go. So you just, to pull him, the easy way, just stack me on this wall here and he'll come right to you. When he does the block, his little ooze block like that, boom.
You're right there.
Oh shit. Oh, missed
you
it.
Missed.
Fuck.
You missed.
I didn't go unblockable.
You missed.
I'm sorry. Alright, get him.
At least you're recording.
Oh shit.
You know, I don't know if Wall of Reflection actually does anything here.
I put it up. Yeah, it does.
It does?
Yeah. It's that freaking thing of his.
Alright, I'm sanctuarying.
Sweet.
He's just out of reach of it. Damn.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, he's fine.
I got line of warding out for the blue ones.
All right, well, make sure if you're fighting this ooze champ, to the eyes watching this video, don't stack literally on top of him. Doing that, well, when he does that little 360 glob spam of his, you're gonna get killed in one hit. It takes you from full HP to zero in like half a second. And I'm not kidding.
Oh, and right there, we just proved that we can that you can four man ooze.
We three-man him on 49.
Yeah, I know, but like, oh. I've done pugs where like we actually can't kill him.
Yo.
Like
those
pugs. they don't know what they're doing, and it's a level 49.
Gosh. People, man, you can buy your way to higher flackles these days with AR, but you can't put the skills on the player. Did we get both rods, by the way?
I grabbed one, and I think Pearls is almost there. Pearls is so close.
You get him,
so
Pearl.
Damage.
Hell yeah.
So close.
All right,
dude, you had a rod over here, and you didn't even put it in.
Yeah,
there, I put one in for him.
All right, so I'm gonna take the second rod. The usual build I
no,
run
actually,
for warrior on this.
No,
is...
don't tank it. Instead, run in for me, so I can just merciful intervention to you.
All right, drop it. No, I got it. I'll make it to that second one right there.
Go. Just go.
Good.
Yeah. Think you can get ahead of me?
I could
breeze you. Here, come. I'll breeze right before.
Damn. I didn't put vigor on myself prior to entering.
It's alright.
Alright, give me like 15 seconds till my bolt charge recharges and I'll do that room. So, 10.
Oh, Pearls is almost there. And we put in two rods, so he should be able to res now pretty easily.
6, 5. Where's the 2 and go? Die. Alright, I'm gonna die because of vengeance, but just res me. Yeah, as a warrior, the skills for running that is usually bolt charge, your vigor, so warhorn, and the little six sync for it. What you do is on lower levels, because, well, yeah, on any level aside from 40-50, you just run in and poof. Pop your bolt charge, evade twice, and then immediately spam the one button. I screwed up a little bit on that, because I didn't do any of those moves, like, you know, the usual way I did it, I just went in and poof. But that's how you usually get through the room, the easy way. So I'm gonna go back to my normal build. And poof. Alright, this is two ways of fighting. You do range and you do melee. I'm going to be doing melee since I'm a PSEA warrior. On pug teams, you want to tell them, hey guys, I'm PSEA, you know, stay within 600 range of me, so it's between me and Fog over here. Right around there-ish. Yep, the 600 range, that way they get my stacks and the good stuff. So here we go.
If you have an Ellie in your group, you want to make sure that they pre-stack Might and they drop Ice Bow and use Glyph of Storms and Air Attunement just for a really nice fat burst at the beginning.
Yep. So, alright, also, bring your own stability. I do trust the Guardians, yes, but it's always good to bring your own stability. This boss does knock you down, And sometimes it's on a blinking panel, and that's bad juju. Thief, you want to use your I think shadow utility that lets you teleport. That'll save you once, and then you have to wait for the recharge. Other than that, we are ready to go. So
alright, I'm gonna hog ground on him for you.
Alright. Here's might stacks, and here's a banner. And here I go with the might stacks. Alright, panel stakes take around like 3 to 5 seconds to disappear, so you do have time to stay there and leave for a little bit. And pew. And you're saving your stability for, you know, when you really need it. Don't just pop it, all that good stuff. For Guardian, I will have a bit up later. But for now, I usually take hold the line, stand your ground, and retreat. Retreat for the run speed. And hold the line and stand your ground for the team. Little regen and stability for when I'm watching the teammates and I see them either fall down or about to, you know, get killed. I'm back on the boss. Alright, for the boss you can attack him from like about a panel away, like right around here ish, melee wise, if you're one of those melee guys. Oops. There's no way of attacking him now, but...
Hey, thanks for that bomb.
I'm sorry, I'm trying to kill storage here.
What? You monster!
Where'd he go?
I'm over here meleeing the boss.
Oh. I was following Pearls.
Oh,
I thought
my
it was
gosh.
You.
Pearl, he's trying to kill us, bro. We should take him out. Alright, ready up. And see you on next stage. Hopefully it's Molten. If it's my train, I'm going to retrain everything. Oh, come on. It's a slow loader. Probably Molten. Oh, we got Ma.
Oh, lame.
Alright, Ma is pretty much... I'm sorry, go ahead.
Keep PSEA up, because I'm going to keep blinds up on the tentacles. That's fine. But
so
I thought you were doing a warrior video.
Yeah, well, no one really needs a warrior video for Ma. Just spam rifle on it, I guess. Camp rifle. Yeah, you heard it, guys. Camp rifle on Ma, that's about it. I mean, great sword, and... Or I usually go rifle axe shield, because I love axe shield. Switching a thief now. Oh, I played a new build. So one thief has traveler runes, this one, and then this one here. My new thief build is like 2,800 base power. Pew pew. All right, go ahead and start, Ma, and I'll join you guys as soon as I'm in. I could outrun a centaur. All right, for thief, I'm usually using short bow and pistol dagger. Short bow is like, really use it anyway. This one's got the strength rune set, so full ascended, and then might runes, or strength runes, and then this is DPS, and this is crit chance. Always have crit chance on your weapons. A lot of people, you know, they run different stuff, but I love to crit, so, pew. Crit chance on this thief is a lot lower than I usually run for. I usually have 84% crit chance on full food and all that, and this one's gonna go to like 74, 76. These are the traits, you can look them up later if you have a thief, and I'm going to join the team in Fractals now. Alright, there's tricks to thief on this level, you know, you do the dark field and all that good stuff, but for this I'm just going to do a normal way, the usual way I do it. So I take a smoke screen for the blinds. Blinds are important on the stage, and I've got Invigorating Precision and the Signet of Malice. You can change it off for any other heal signet. Like the evade one, the evade one's pretty good. That'll save you against Ma if you run out of evade. But I use the Malice Signet anyway. Alright, I'm gonna join the team. We're gonna start meleeing the next. Are we meleeing or ranging?
I messed up.
I usually range this first part just because I hate trying to aggro the mobs.
No problem. I'm
and then I switch to melee here.
I'm safe for a bit. Where are you at?
No, forget it. Just hold the CF through the tentacles.
Alright, I'm gonna fight this. Alright, dropping my smoke screen now.
We still have one up.
What the
heck?
Yeah,
I was trying to fight the 4-1.
That was a bad start. What was I attacking? Can you get me up? I'm dead. I'll just wait for an OC. Dude, it's higher levels. They hit harder. Yeah.
I should not have tried to save you guys.
Wow, that tank
was... Ark went vengeance. Go, Ark.
Oh, screenshot.
Oh, did I get it before you got screenshot?
All right, oh, I'm joking about the screenshotting thing this entire time. Just Rocket said to say it every time you died.
You bastard. He's got like 3 screenshots of me online.
Ah, damn it, I almost got you pearls.
What a sneaky person. I'm not used to running without speed boosts. Like, I have Traveler set on my thief, so you can't get me.
I almost got pearls.
No, you didn't.
Rocket has taught me his ways.
Yeah, oh my gosh, you gotta stay away from that guy, he's a bad influence. He's trying to kill you.
I was there at the Guardian Troll guy.
Oh my gosh. Alright, see him attacking the tentacle a little there. I really wanted to do the lifesteal trait, but not today. We need a Necro for it. This is one of the only times, guys, that I'll actually favor a Necro on the team. Other than that, screw it. Necros.
Ew, gross. You like Necros?
No.
What?
Filthy casual.
Alright. Start working on this tentacle over here. Are we going over there? I'll join you. Alright, so as a thief, your job is to blind spam the heck out of mobs. I'm going to go ahead and use the move here. What I use is Steak and Asparagus for power and precision, and also Bountiful Sharpening Stones for the might evade. 25 seconds of might on evade, and the reason for that is strength rune 6. 5% damage under the effects of might, so you're doing a little bit more damage also. Alright, so at this part, I usually switch off from the invigorating precision, and I'm going to go to executioner. So as soon as I OOC, I'm switching creeps. There we go. And then poof. Just spamming pistol 3, or. And blinding. So I'm gonna go join Fog over there. So this cripple is off.
Perfect timing, I was out of blinds.
Rob, got you, bro.
Oh, got stability.
Got him. What is my thing? I have 72% crit chance right now. So cool. Let's get this tentacle over here.
Someone's got skull. I don't know who.
This guy.
I'm always so scared because I'm inside the hitbox and I don't see it until it's like too late sometimes.
Right here. I wonder how much I hit with backstab on this guy.
Only oh, it's me.
See you, bro.
Oh, see,
you're
see,
down.
I didn't see it disappear.
There you go. You rallied on the tentacle. I wonder if I can hit like a 17k backstab. You think so?
Maybe
15, 16.
I mean, anything is possible.
Yeah. I mean, on the tentacles and stuff. I just need my stacks. I don't have those.
I mean, I'm sorry I'm not running Scepter. Or Staff, I mean.
Staff. No, I'm not talking about you. I'm just wondering how high I can hit. I've never actually tried it. I do miss my 84% crit chance though. 72 would suck. Let's hit this tentacle behind me.
Oh crap. Oh, yeah, this is too slow. Right there.
yeah, I saw it. I thought it was dead.
Here, let me strip real quick.
grab.
It'll be a while till you guys actually get me. Oh, never mind.
Shoot, I'm down.
Pearl, no. You gotta grab Crystal. The Chev.
Hey, look, everyone's out of combat.
Yeah, but she's almost
just keeping them all up.
Yeah, no. It'd take longer.
I'm hit this tentacle. Alright, just melee Zerg on me and then we'll be good. We have been in this stage for approximately 42 minutes.
This stage?
I mean, this stage, this fractal.
That's horrible timing.
My bad. Well, I don't know.
Wow.
We got, like,
I'm failing right now.
Just kick. time yellow or time yellow? Can tell you random stuff. Let me go for the backstab. I got it. Sort of. Oh crap. I'm here. Here I am. Pearl, watch out. Over your head.
Did you steal his crystal?
No, I did not. I was down. He double evaded.
I was gonna go for another crystal when he went down.
I'm so sorry. Here is a blind. Oh gosh. Hey, instead of screenshotting it, I have all our deaths on video, by the way.
Oh yeah, that's perfect. That'll make Rocket happy.
I think he has a personal folder of like hundreds of pictures of just us dying.
Yeah, he said he's got one of you dying.
Yeah, he said he linked me like three pictures of me and my death in my last night. I was like, what the heck, bro? Who does this? Who does this?
Hey, everybody gets bored once in a while.
Still,
like, they need a pick me up.
It's supposed to be only like on dumb stuff, but like you shoot. Hammer toing off fractal heartbeats. Oh shit. Got that.
Oh, whoa, we're done. We're done.
Are we?
Yeah.
Alright, good luck on your drops.
Wait, good luck on droppings.
No, this
you
is
guys wanna do a.
How long is this run? Because we have 16 minutes on.
Look at the food. Let's see, math, that's. 44.
Oh yeah. That was
like good luck on droppings.
44 minutes.
That sucks. She's going on my 30s. Alright. Statistically speaking, oh, Soldier Spine Guard. You can sell that. Rare.
Oh, 44 is bad, right?
Yeah, horrible.
It's really slow.
It's because we had this guy here. Alright, here we go.
Stupid ring.
Oh, wow. Got a ring.
Ring,
see, I waste all my luck rolling swamp for you guys.
Thank you for the swamp rolls. You...
Get it right away every time. Alright, so we're gonna do a 37 after this.
I wonder if Rocket's online. I wanna go there. Oh, there's a new rank in Guild, by the way. It's Prodigy. It's for the guys who can and are able to 2 or 3 man fractals. And to get in, you have to earn it. So you have to do a 2-3 man fractal at least on tier 4 or higher 2 times. With the other Prodigy.
Okay. What's tier 4?
It's 31 and up.
Okay, are we counting that first time me and Pearls ran with you?
I mean, you guys are good. You guys are able to. Oh, shit, I forgot about that.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, there you go. And log. This will make it easier to find, like, because the Primarchs are 50 with AR, but, you know, you can get that with gold.
Yeah.
I know the remarkable for this.
Alright, so if we do a 37 after this, I'm going to switch to Elementalist.
Going. I'm probably gonna
go just to make it faster.
I don't know, I like guardians and warriors.
Yeah, well look at our party, it's nothing but guardians and warriors,
yeah,
except for you who just
two
switched
guardians,
at the end.
Three warriors. Good enough.
From this party, is it 4 of us are in Oracle?
Yeah, except for Ark. Yeah. Ark is not Oracle. I can't do anything. I have to salvage this spine guard because you can't do anything with it. Oh, I got like 3 hard leather sessions. Let me go put this stuff in a bank and shoot. Start. I don't think Ark's gonna go with us on this next run, so we might have to pick up a different another warrior or something.
Well, I'm not gonna go Guardian, so. Just saying.
Either. I might go Guardian for the gameplay. But other than that, it's whatever. How many did I get today on Thief? 5, 4. There you go. My relic collection is glowing. There you go.
What do you guys think is the best reward from the chest of royalty?
Laurels, definitely laurels. Because you can get the other stuff with gold. Laurels you cannot.
I don't know. What value do laurels have to you?
A lot.
Like, what will you buy with them?
Cat tonic. You're the cat tonic man. Calling you out.